This screencast will take a look at developing a mathematical model for where an energy balance is required. The problem statement is provided on the screen, which discusses the stirred tank heater, which allows for the heating of a fluid. So the inlet stream comes in at a mass flow rate W and an inlet temperature TI and exits at that same flow rate W and at temperature T. The fluid is heated by the use of a heating coil provided at the bottom of the diagram, in which a constant rate of energy of rate Q is provided to the heater. The volume of the liquid inside the stirred tank heater is volume V. So first, before we enter the energy balance, let's show the fact that the mass balance for this does not really provide much guidance. So if we look at our mass balance first, we recognize the fact that there is no generation, no reaction going, if there's no chemical reaction occurring. In the inlet flow rate is W, and the outlet flow rate is W. So what that means is the fact that the accumulation in this mass balance is zero. So all this is really telling us is that the volume inside the tank is a constant. So now that we've shown that our mass balance doesn't provide any real fruitful information, we can now go to our energy balance, which is that accumulation of energy equals in minus out, energy in minus energy out, plus energy from a chemical reaction, plus energy from the surroundings. An important point to note here is the fact that the sign for the chemical reaction surroundings have been provided here as positive. You have to be very aware of the signs that you're using. So for example, for an exothermic chemical reaction, the value for this term should be a positive because the temperature of the process inside the system is going to increase. So to begin this energy balance, we'll skip the accumulation term for the time being and we'll focus on the right-hand side. The information we have for our in term is the mass flow rate and the temperature. What we need is an energy. So recall from thermodynamics that we can get some idea of an energy per mass basis by the use of enthalpy, H. So if we multiply enthalpy, which has units typically of energy either per mole or per mass, here we'll go on a per mass basis. And if we multiply it by the mass flow rate W, which has units of mass per time, we get our desired units of energy per time. Our in term will be W times the inlet enthalpy of the fluid minus the outlet stream, which is W, now will be times H out, the enthalpy of the exiting stream. There's no chemical reaction going on, so that term goes to zero. And now we have to look at the surroundings term. So our system here has a heating coil, which is providing heat at a rate of Q. For our control volume is the inside of the stirred tank heater. This is energy being added to the system. Therefore, we're going to want to have this as a plus Q. And our accumulation term for now we'll leave as d energy dt. So d energy dt inside this derivative, what we need to find is the amount of energy that is inside the tank that the fluid has. So to determine the energy inside the tank, we actually take a very similar approach to how we handle the inlet and the outlet streams, where we're going to be interested in multiplying the mass of fluid in the tank multiplied by the energy per mass. So first, let's find the mass of the fluid in the tank. We know the fact that the volume inside the tank of fluid is constant based on the mass balance at a value of V. In order to convert from volume to mass, we multiply by rho. In order to get the energy per mass, that again is just simply the enthalpy, but in this case, the enthalpy of the tank. And this will equal the energy term that's in our differential equation. With this information, we can restate our energy balance as d rho VH tank dt equals the right-hand side. From thermodynamics, we can express what the value of the enthalpy is. We can say that for systems with constant heat capacity, that H can be expressed as the heat capacity multiplied by the temperature of which the fluid is at minus some reference temperature. And what we'll now do is substitute this definition of enthalpy into our energy balance where enthalpy is located, which is at the tank, the inlet stream and the outlet stream. The derivative will now become rho V Cp times T, which is the temperature inside the tank. Since the tank is well mixed, that means the fact that the temperature of the outlet stream of T is identical to the temperature inside the tank. So therefore, this will just be T minus T ref dT. Our in turn becomes W times Cp. Here, the inlet stream enters at Ti. So it'll be Ti minus T ref. We can do a very similar evaluation for the outlet stream, which is at temperature T, and then we add the Q term. We can now take advantage of some simplifications. On the left-hand side, the reference temperature is a constant value. Therefore, if we take the derivative with respect to time, the value of the T ref part will go to zero. Although dT ref dT goes to zero, dT dT does not. On the right-hand side, we see the fact that we have negative WCP T ref. And then for our second term, we have the same terms, except with an additional minus sign. So therefore, the T ref terms are going to cancel out, an occurrence that is relatively common when doing these energy balances. After these simplifications, we're left with the following. The last step here is to take out a few constants out of the derivative. The problem statement stated that rho and heat capacity were constants, and based on our mass balance, we know that the volume is a constant. So therefore, we can take all those out of the derivative to get us to our final answer, which is that rho V Cp dT dT equals WCP multiplied by the difference between the inlet temperature and the outlet temperature, which is also the tank temperature, plus Q.